Hello everyone. This tutorial is all about the preferences dialog box, and yes, it requires the video all to itself. Preferences are the settings you choose to determine how your avatar will function within Second Life. This isn't the most interesting of subjects, I know, but it will certainly improve your Second Life experience to set these up early on. As an aside to those well used to Second Life, I'm aware that this video will not in any way cover all of the things that you can do with your preferences. I think any attempt to do so would make for a very long video and be impractical to make. Firestorm has so many choices. The aim of this video is to point out some of the most useful settings. Of course, this is my opinion, and you can make your own choices. I'm just hoping to guide newcomers so that they can see what's available and hopefully continue to make choices that will work for them. So, that having been said, let's get on with the video. Okay, so let's start looking at the preferences dialog box. You can find it by going to Avatar and Preferences. As I hover here, notice that it shows the keyboard shortcut, which is Control P. Click here and the box will open. Of course, we can make it easier by customising your GUI. If you watch my second tutorial, you will know how to do this, but I'll remind you. Right-click on any of these buttons at the bottom of the screen and choose Toolbar Buttons. A dialog box will come up and you'll find preferences in there. Just drag the icon to where you would like it on your screen. So here is the preferences box. On the left hand side you'll see there are lots and lots of tabs. We will not be covering even half of them. I'm just going to pick out some of the better settings that I think will help you. I will also show you how to adjust your graphics. I did promise in my first tutorial that I may be able to ease the load on your machine a little, so this is me keeping my promise. Let's start with the General tab. At the bottom are the Away Timeout and the Logout Timeout settings. It's very easy to find yourself logged out if you don't set these to Never, because real life is a distraction. If you're in the middle of something important in Second Life and get called away in real life, not changing these to Never will potentially lose you what you've been doing. Now let's go to the Chat tab. As you can see, this tab has plenty of its own tabs along the top as well. Let's change something so you look less like a newcomer. One thing that all newcomers do is have their avatar's hands type while they chat. People who have been in Second Life for a while don't tend to do this. If they do, they will usually use a specific typing animation gadget. If you'd like to stop the endless typing animation when you chat, you should find the Typing tab in this Chat tab section. At the top, you'll see Play Typing Animation While Chatting. It is usually set as on by default, which is why all newcomers are doing it. Make sure it's not checked and you'll look less like a newbie. Now let's look at the Graphics tab. You'll definitely want to become familiar with this. If you look at the first screen here, what you see may look very confusing. There are some functions on here that you do need to know to make your Second Life graphics more functional. This bar along the top is one of the easiest ways to help your computer cope with SL graphics. Depending on the quality of your computer, you will be able to run from low to ultra. If you use ultra, you will need a pretty powerful computer. I can run it, but the load is quite intense, so I only use it for SL photography, which is a thing. We'll cover that thing. However, I will show you the difference now. As you can see, I have this set at mid. I'll now turn it up to ultra. Now I've changed the setting, you can see the depth and shadows. If I cam into my avatar, you'll see that her face looks that much smoother and realistic. It's a great setting if your computer can handle it, but lower settings will put less load on your computer. If you find that you can't move easily and it takes a very long time to be able to see anything, then lower your settings on the bar. Another important bar to this section is the draw distance. Depending on where your top bar is set will depend on where this is set by default. The draw distance is how far you can see into the distance. If you want to be able to see far off objects, then you would raise the draw distance. There isn't much point for me to change this here, as we're currently in a house in the sky, or a skybox as they're more commonly known. Adjusting this setting may help you get a better experience, but if you have it set high and your computer is struggling, turn it down. Some of the other settings we'll leave for now. I will mention this setting though. Avatar physics can be quite a surprise to newcomers. Avatar physics is the ability of your avatar to move more realistically. Specifically, the chest, belly and butt area for ladies, and mostly the butt for guys. So you may well see avatars that when they move, they sway in all the right places. If you don't want to see this movement, you can turn this off. Avatar physics are customizable and are actually worn as an item of clothing. We'll cover these in the clothing video. When I film these videos, I don't wear avatar physics because let's concentrate on the video, shall we? And now the sound and media tab. You may already be frustrated with Second Life if you don't find typing very easy. You can speak to people using your computer or an external microphone in Second Life. I don't use my voice very much in Second Life, except when I'm doing my radio show, and that's over the stream. I prefer to communicate by typing, as we are a radio station, and talking in voice would get in the way of the music. We don't actually allow avatars to speak in voice on our parcel because of this. However, there are plenty of places where you may prefer to talk to people just like you would on a telephone. If you have a headset or speakers and a microphone, then you can do this. Click on the voice tab and enable voice. You may find it's already enabled. You may choose to listen from your camera position, which allows you to move your virtual microphone with your camera. Or you can listen from your avatar position, which locks your virtual mic over your avatar. Once you've enabled voice, put in your device settings. If you've done it right, then you will see the bars flash when you talk. You may also wish to allow your avatar's lips to move when you use voice. I've enabled voice on our parcel so you can see how it looks. Note the white dot above my head and the green bars flash when I talk, as well as my avatar's lips moving. Let's look at the Move and View tab, because I'd like to point out a neat trick if you're a lazy shopper. If I go into a shop, especially a big shop, I don't want to walk around. I find a comfortable place to stand and I use my camera to look around the shop. If you check Disable Camera Constraints and Disable Minimum Camera Zoom Distance, you'll be able to do this too. Or simply cam out when you arrive at a new location to check it out. If you can't seem to get your original camera view back when you use this, press the Escape key and your view will return to normal. If we go into the Movement tab, you can set whether you use the arrow keys to move or the W, A, S and D keys. Many gamers will be used to using the letter keys, so they may prefer them. Something I always like to have activated is the double click on land, because, as I said, I'm lazy. If I'm in a large sim, I will probably cam around before moving anywhere. If I see somewhere far away that I want to go, I can simply double click on that spot and my avatar will be instantly teleported there. One last thing. I'm only showing you a small taste of what you can do with Firestorm. Your go-to place for help in world should be the Firestorm support group. You can find it by using the search function. If you've not got the button on your screen, right-click a button, choose toolbar buttons, find search and drag it down. Type in Firestorm in the groups section and you'll see a whole list. Gypsy belongs to the Firestorm support English group. I would suggest you join and ask for help in group instant message if you have any problems. When I say any problems, I mean any that you can't find on Firestorm Wiki, which should be your first port of call. Go to firestormviewer.org and on the top bar choose Wiki. Get familiar with Wiki and you'll not go far wrong. I hope this video has taught you a few useful things. Join me in the next one, where we'll start to look at customising your avatar. Thank you for watching.